Because MC fell for his trick.
Yeah.
Simply put, the 11 gate made it so convincing on top of the fact that the gas was taken a little bit later. So, guys, we're now into the game. Let's take you there.
Yeah, and as we scroll into Entune Valley pretty soon here, got to get that scoreboard adjusted.
Ooh,
so
we do
have
actually
the
need
proper
to upgrade.
Numbers there. Do not worry about that, guys. In the top left-hand location, we have the blue Protoss player from SK Gaming. He is currently down 1-0 on the verge of being eliminated from the MLG 2012 Winter Championships. It is MC. And in the bottom right-hand location, his opponent, the red Protoss player representing Quantic Gaming on the verge of advancing on Championship Sunday. His name is Nanny Wong. Another PvP going on here, and I wonder what's going to happen because last game was electrifying, so exciting. Nanny Wong able to take it relatively convincingly, coming out on top of the correct mind games, fooling MC a little bit. I'm excited.
More than just a little bit. He sent him straight into a boomerang, sent completely in one direction did MC go. And it was, it was a three gate is what it was. He went for a three gate play.
Yeah.
And had the potential for a little bit of aggression there if his opponent was not four gating. Perhaps the lack, see, that's the beauty of the three gate play, by the way, with stalkers included, is if Nanny was, there's two possibilities that Nanny was going for. One is that Nanny was going to four gate you. The other is that, or likely possibilities we should say, is that Nanny is intending to expand here.
Sure.
He wants to preserve all the minerals. You know, he only had two on gas. MC noted the lack of gas. And MC wanted to make sure he had the possibility of aggression as well if Nanny was actually going for a really fast expansion play, which is the less likely of the two, and we saw him not be too aggressive, but it created the option of it. Nanny threw him a total curveball there, caught him completely off guard. Here in Game 2, it does not seem off the bat as if Nanny is going for anything quite so tricky.
Yeah, completely standard play for both these players. We saw Nanny again, Chrono boosting the first two Zealot and the Stalker, trying to do some aggression, trying to get some scouting done too. But in this case, okay, he's just not scouting at all. Is he going to try to scout with the Zealot? I mean, he's not chrono boosting it out. It was like a 12 or 13 gate, so a little bit later than last game. The rush distance is incredibly long. So perhaps Nanny Wong, just confident in dealing with any potential cheese, might just scout around his side of the map for potential proxy gateways or proxy forges or something crazy like that. But as of right now, what I love looking at in mirror matchups is the deviations in that production tab. It looks like Nanny Wong getting a Zealot on the field, MC as well getting a Zealot on the field. So both these players essentially identical. Nanny Wong a tad ahead in that stalker count income tab. Exactly the same.
Yeah, Nanua right now a little ahead on his stalker and also grabbed his second gas earlier. If we take a look, he's pulling only about, 10 gas more than his opponent, however. So not too much ahead in that regard, even though it did finish a substantial amount earlier. Currently, chrono boosting his warp gate is MC. Nanua, I don't know that he's doing the same. It looks like MC's far getting a little bit too far ahead here. But if we take a look, we see MC throwing down, you know what, it did just wrap up. Nanua throwing, or MC. The robotics bay being thrown down rather by MC here. And that's the time of robo that MC really appreciates to have. It's a nice, fast robotics facility. Get an observer out, you can get out of mortals and defend against any stalker play that your opponent might throw at you.
Yeah, and you know, you're inherently going to get the tech advantage, assuming your opponent doesn't go for the robo, the same as you. And Nanua here, going for two additional gateways before adding on any additional tech, also throwing down a forward pylon here. So Nanua definitely considering being very aggressive at the early stage of this game.
Absolutely.
And MC has to be careful. Does he build an observer first? Does he build two observers first? Does he get an immortal first? That's going to decide this game, because if he doesn't get an immortal out, Nanua could do a bunch of damage here.
Yeah, we're going to have to see. You know what? He opens up straight away with the Immortal, playing it safe, which I like because it's balanced. He went for this very fast robotics facility. Extreme risk involved with that. And because we see him getting the Immortal right away, he balances the risk to try to now make it a little bit safer. If he had opened up with the Observer, would have proved to be a pretty risky play that would have worked out for him because we see Nanua throwing down the robotics facility behind this, but could have potentially been quite dangerous indeed. Now, MC has a lot of time to buy himself opportunities here because he's got a sentry in position that will have two force fields.
Yeah.
First one getting ready to drop, and it does. Zealot going to be taken out here. Doesn't want to lose that sentry, however. It does get knocked down all the way into the yellow.
Ooh, yeah, MC should be just fine here. But the thing is, Nanywall saw the Immortal, knows the timing of his opponent's robotics facility, and look at this, MC doing exactly what Nanywall did last game, going for the extremely fast robotics spay, and Nanywall following it up with the same exact thing. Actually, something was being canceled there, perhaps a pylon. Nanywall not needing that, I guess. He's already 42 out of 50 supply. But here we go. Are we going to see Speed Prism with two Immortals, or are we going to see Colossi? What do you think?
Well, you know, you pointed out that Nanywall knows the robotics timing here from MC. Because he knows that timing, he's going to be able to react accordingly. I would suspect that Nanywall's going to play a little defensive here because he knows he's behind on tech and he can't move out across the board easily. But we've got something very interesting here coming from MC, Axel.
You know, Nanywall might do the exact same thing. And that would make me the happiest person on the planet. Nothing more fun than seeing two Protoss players going for Speed War Prism and going for Immortals. Please click Ravidic Drive. Nanywall, please make me a happy
it
person.
It is. You're absolutely right, though. I don't know if you guys happen to catch, Axel, if you caught at Assembly White Rom versus JYP.
Yes.
But those Immortal drops versus Immortal drops are so entertaining to watch. But it appears at this moment as if we're having Nanywall go for the Colossus. And
yes,
he's not going to have one out quite in time here to deal with these drops from MC. It's going to pop out as the drop is occurring, but
no.
Nanywall needs to be careful with his army positioning right now. I mentioned how I expected Nanywall to play more defensively after realizing the robotics timing of MC, and he seems to not doing that. His army's really out of position right now, Axel.
This is not good for Nanywall. He's completely left his base. His entire army is in the middle of the map. Meanwhile, MC dropping Immortals in Nanywall's main base. Nanywall immediately pulling his units back, and that is a pylon, which is going to unpower three gateways. MC taking that down. Pylon's trying to attack, or Probes, I should say, trying to attack these Immortals, but we all know how effective that is. And oh my god, the Immortals could target down the Colossi. This could be huge for MC. Takes down the Colossus with those two Immortals, but loses. No, he puts the Immortal back in that worship at the same time. Nanywall pushing the main base of MC.
And both Immortals were actually preserved there. Shields taken out on the second one as well, which was surrounded by Probes. MC now defending against the all-in push from Nanywall with ease. He's got himself a number of sentries. He even added Colossus to this composition. There's not much Nanywall can do from here.
Wow, look at the Harvest Jab, and there's the GG. Oh my gosh, MC taking that game, perhaps build order wise, but what it came down to was Nanywall leaving his base, going to the middle of the map, caught completely off guard by those two Immortals that just started wrecking absolutely everything, taking down that pylon, taking down that Colossus, taking down a bunch of Probes. We saw the income at the end of that game was like 25 to 15.
You know,
and
we
then Nanywall
see this.
Countered, and MC was able to defend it pretty easily with the force fields.
Yeah, I mean, Nanywall is a player who does have greedy tendencies about him, which is perfectly fine to play with a little greed. It ultimately wins Nanywall a ton of games. But what we saw there was Nanywall not wanting to sacrifice a probe to run out into the map and see if MC actually had a unit, for example, at the Zelnaga Tower. So he moved his whole army out to make it look like he was coming for a gateway Immortal timing. And his Colossus was only about halfway done when he left his base, maybe even a quarter of the way done. And there's not much reason to do that unless you intend to assert map control or hide information. So, Nanywall moving out with his entire army there, assuming MC held the Zelnaga Tower. Whether he did or didn't, it didn't really matter. Ultimately, MC able to capitalize on the mistake there out of Nanywall and do it quite well. Colossus got sniped with ease, and MC made a transition into a beautiful defense. So, MC tying up the series, guys, at 1-1. Axel, are we going to get ourselves into Game 2 here?
Yeah, or Game 3,
or
because
game
they
three,
are tied
me.
1-1. But yeah, just phenomenal play from MC there. Just pulling out the trick of the Speed Prism as we wait for the map choice from Nanywall. You know, this is like this might be one of the most important decisions made at MLG. This is Championship Sunday, MLG 2012 Winter Championships. People, players getting eliminated left and right. And this game, it's going to determine who stays alive on Championship Sunday and who's going home.
You know, Nanywall, I think he wants a map with a lot of versatility. He feels as if, and we've seen it in Game 1. In Game 1, we saw Nanywall trick MC. Now, it's easier to trick your opponent if you have more options available to you. So I would expect to see here maps that are able to easily utilize strategies like Blink Stalker. Also, if they're smaller and can lend themselves towards Colossus play and Robotics, the more options Naniwa has to work with, I think the better he's going to feel. So maps like Dual Sight has a moderate amount of blink. I don't think you can actually blink out of the top base. Antigua would be a great one with the blink possibilities, Chikris. But it's a little bit rough for that Robo, and I think MC likes the macro style of play. It is, after all, going to be Antigua Shipyard. Naniwa does have the option here of going with that blink style of play and a lot of other things as well, but MC's not going to hate this map choice.